collapse. Where you see any building collapsing in the hood or whatever, with 3 alarm fires, 4 alarm fires, the building is still, the structure's still intact. Mm-hmm. So that building, World Trade, it was huge. Mm-hmm. The thing, it imploded within itself. They pulled the building, man. Mm-hmm. And that's a loophole. They could never cover that up. All right? Because it didn't get hit with the plane. So how did that fall? But people say, nah, see, you dealing with that conspiracy. Right? Because they really believe that some Arab in some cave masterminded this great plan and sent his agents over here. They hijacked a plane with box cutters and was able to send it into the building. Even though the Illuminati playing card game came out way before that and showed you the destruction.
Literally.
Before. But nah, it was come on, man. People. And these are the same people that told you to took Maxine.
Yeah.
People won't learn, man. All right?
And the way they designed the new tower, it resembles a fucking...
It like a needle, yeah.
Like a needle, man. And that's the year they started really pushing in 2021.
Yeah.
But 2021 marked what? 20 years after 9/11, man. You see? So... You people were always falling for the okie doke, man.
Yeah, the simple... How long... The scripture says, the simple, let's get at Proverbs 14:15. World Trade Center, that was devastating, man. On the side, okay. But people forgot. Like Roy Jones did that song, you motherfuckers forgot, man. Must have forgot. They did forget. You know, they forgot C-19. You know, last year around this time, when you go in certain places, people were masked up and it was empty. It was not even much people around like that. People still were masked up to their eyes, even though they had all one, two, three in them. You know, they just now got comfortable taking that stupid shit off, man. Alright? They back to their shit again, but that's the scriptures. You know? As it was in the days of Noah.
Yep.
See? What you got?
Proverbs 14:15. The simple believeth every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his going.
A prudent, a wise man searches everything out, man. We don't take enough for face value, especially not from the prince of the poverty here. Alright? Anytime he says something, we research it. C-19. We know nothing about, I mean, we heard of SARS, the virus, but we ain't know nothing about no C-19 and the vaccines. We know what the basic vaccines, and we knew about, they experimented in time spats, but this whole C-19, brothers, damn, they became scientists. You know, we were researching, they're linking shit together, you know, and just brought it out, man. That was the spirit of the Lord,
man.
Yes,
it was, yeah.
You see, did not the Most High say it was Isaiah 42:9? You see, but people say, oh, well, you're not, we going to believe the medical experts. Well, what happened to you now?
You're finished.
All right? Now, everybody know Fauci full of shit, man. See, but everybody was listening to him back then. Serve your ass right. Was Isaiah 42:9?
Isaiah chapter 42, verse 9. Behold, the former things are come to pass, and new things do I declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them.
Yeah, so anything spring forth, the Lord, tell of it, put it in your spirit, right? Directly got the angels charged to keep the night waves. Right? You look up information, you start finding things fast, man. Right? That's the inspiration from the Almighty. And then you bring it out. Bring it out to the believers, man. And even people who don't believe. I'll tell you that Jeremiah 1:10, prophet of the nations.
Prophet of the nations.
I've told people, have no dealings with that. That's a trap. That's an obvious trap. It's a prelude to this, the MOTB and that system, the CBDC that's coming, everything digitized, right? In order for you to go anywhere, you got to show that you have this, man. All right? That's the system that they want in place. Instead of being the Maxine passport, it's going to be something else in your hand.
That's right.
That's all that was, man. Mm-hmm. Plus, they connected that same, this earlier this year, they have the five towers. They said they were going to turn it up. Then they have their five towers up, man. They made that announcement. All these companies are switching over to five towers. Mm-hmm. So everything links all together, man. You know? So we're going to see the zombie thing next.
That's right. And that's not far-fetched at all.
Yeah.
If the Heavenly Father can make Nebuchadnezzar on a level of beast where he's literally eating grass like an ox, it's not far-fetched to see niggas running around biting necks. Okay? We're going to see that, man. Man, we see it, man. That's definitely in the realm of possibility.
Just says men hearts failing them, so you're gonna see all kind of crazy things out here.
Right.
Cannibalism gonna be a normal thing. You know?
That's right.
Eating human flesh.
Yeah.
Because it happened 70 AD. It happened during the time of the Babylonians. Read the Book of Lamentation. It happened. It happened in the time of 2 Kings. It was the time of Elisha.
Mm-hmm.
It happened. People eating each other's sons. Right? And people back then, like we always said, they were more on a level than the people now. They were built more for hardship than the people now. Everything is comfortable now. You don't got to go to the supermarket, get order. You don't got to cook. Everything is at this, at that. You know, everything is easier now, man.
With the Heavenly Father did it on purpose. It's like the ultimate chess move, man. You know, lining you people up to get major, to catch major hell. Because like the brother just said, through the spirit back then, it was on a different level. So they was able to really deal with hardships. But you people are not used to dealing with hardships in America, man. Or wherever you scattered abroad at, man. You see, mainly in America, these people are just docile. These people are complacent. They're simple. And everything, and they at ease, man. Especially the women, too. They at ease. They're comfortable here. Like brother just mentioned, the different methods you get food. Okay? They're not used to cultivating the ground and waiting to harvest to pick up the right fruits and vegetables.
They don't know what farmers have to go through.
They don't know none of that stuff, man. They don't know how to pluck chickens and, you know, catch nothing. You know, men are not men. These men in America, they are effeminate. Okay? These men in America are just weak. You know?
Yeah.
Homosexuals. Skinny-ass jeans. You know? Pink sweaters. Under they woman. You know? Belly rings. Niggas are weirdos, man. Their nails painted. They're not ready for hardships, man. They're not ready for war. All right? They're not warriors, man.
Yeah, that was a big thing in being a man. Got to be a warrior back then in the ancient world.
That's right.
You had your rites of passage in order to be a man. But we went into that history not too long ago about the Spartans.
Yep. Also the
tribes. Yeah. That's their rites of passage in order to be a man. Like, because in order to, you have to be a leader, man.
Mm-hmm. Which the Lord is raising up men right now. The men of the Lord. Okay, his men. All right? The 144,000, the tabernacle of David, getting risen up right now. We got our manhood back, man. So we have this mindset of kings. Mindset of rulership. Mindset of warriors. Because we are warriors, man. All right? We're battling. We're in the spiritual warfare every day. Yeah. So the Lord put us with our five afflictions. See if we go, you know, endure that, man.
Yeah, this is Israel's supposed to be a warrior race. Supposed to be.
That's right. And that's what with Jake... going to any type of sports, you know, they dominate, man. Especially like, I'm talking like fighting sports, boxing, MMA. Which MMA, remember the brothers bringing it out, it started with eating my seat, you know, slapping it, be dominant, but Jake got up in there,
Jake
and started
got up in there
ass,
and took it over.
Because it's in Jake's spirit. Like Mike Tyson, man, this dude was knocking people out in the first round, man. Clean. You see? People were scared of Mike Tyson, man. You know? It'd be funny because Mike was young, he was 19, 20. You know, knocking out 25-year-olds, 27-year-olds, 30-year-olds that have been in it for a minute. Big and broad. You know, Mike Tyson, he had a certain style, man. You see? Oh, you had Joe Frazier, you know, Benjamin with his left hook. Benjamin, the left-handed, you know, the left hooks, man. Broke Muhammad Ali's jaw. And Muhammad Ali was, you know, known as the greatest boxing, the greatest boxer, man.
Yeah, okay.
And he had the Ali shuffle quick, big and quick. That's Jake, man. So we had that warrior spirit. And that's on the low level. King David was leaving over walls, man. Samson saw 1,000 Philistines, okay?
Yeah, they not on the level of those guys.
Oh, the 37
even,
mighty men.
Even the gladiators.
That's right.
Because the gladiator wasn't just a sport, it was death.
It was death. It was you fighting to death.
Yeah, the Spartacus and all of that. Those were Jakes, man.
Even Jakes during the Byzantine Empire, it was just fight to death, man.
Yeah,
have
yeah.
duels.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
have a duel to the death.
Yeah, they said let God decide. That's how they
That's
decided
right.
a lot of battles, conflicts.
Right.
They said let God decide the winner.
That's right.
You know?
And the Most High always does. He ordained the winner.
Well, that's what Judas Maccabees said.
Yeah. Victory coming from heaven.
It comes from heaven.
That's right.
He decide who gonna win and who doesn't.
That's right.
Most High controls all that, man.
So guess what, Esau? Who gonna win this battle? We are.
Yeah, that's because this is a spiritual war.
That's right. That's right.
Right.
And when it get physical, ooh, the Lord can raise up his men. Isaiah 59:19.
Yep.
The Lord can raise up his men. Because it's in our spirit that, and yo, that's how brothers have dreams of spiritual power. We be getting down, man. We be getting down. And the brother had a dream. Esau said, oh, we got something for that. We know spiritual power's coming. We got something for that.
Yeah, this is top military guys.
And that's what they call what the Black Awakening. When they bring forth their troops that's going to try to, you know, to harm the Christians. Who are the true Christians? The Jakes, Israelites. Christians, where? We
showed you, much. Yeah. They showed you that in Turkey.
Yes, yep. Because we had projects slaughtering Jake, man. You got this one Eve with a little handgun popping up, trying to pop. Then she got. You got that one Jake that was kind of like, you know, old macho Jake in there. You know, he did his thing. I ain't gonna lie.
because, you know, if Skeletor saved his ass in the end.
Yeah.
What the fuck is going on? It just started.
Yeah. Instead of going game, all these troops, he's on his slicing. He was crazy.
Yo, Skeletor was a funny villain, man.
He was, man. That was a good movie, man. The Purge. All the Purge series, man. Even the last one, the fourth Purge.
I didn't see that one, actually.
It was good. It wasn't as good as the one before it, though. That's my personal opinion. But it shows some the symbolism of what the forever purge. A purge will last forever, a long duration of time. It's not just a one day, every year thing. It's gonna be like, oh, hell breaking loose soon, man. And they always show Jake and Issachar. It shows both kingdoms. That one was literally mainly for Issachar. You know, they crossed the border. They tried to leave America for Mexico. They was trying to get a body.
Bro, they was trying to leave.
They was trying to get a body. You got a whole bunch of people like in a bus trying to leave America. This place is bad, man. Yeah, I think that took place in Texas. That one, Forever Purge. Yeah.
I got a precept.
Gotta bring it up.
This is Micah, because brother was going into the miracles that the Lord is going to do for us. So this is Micah chapter 7 verse 15 in the NLT. It says, yes, says the Lord, I will do mighty miracles for you, like those I did when I rescued you from slavery in Egypt. All the nations of the world will stand amazed at what the Lord will do for you. They will be embarrassed at their feeble power. They will cover their mouths in silent awe, deaf to everything to around them. See that here? So the brothers are saying that the Lord is going to lift up a standard for us. Okay, he's going to give certain brothers spiritual power, and he's going to do miracles for some of the elect. Okay, those miracles are going to be so amazing that the nations, Esau and these other nations, when they come down with great wrath, that they're going to be amazed at it. So they're going to cover their hand over their mouth. And all Zacchaeus is amazed at their fearful power, because you know Esau right now, he's boasting in his blessing that Isaac gave him, the sword. You see that he got all this technology and power to like for mass destruction, but when he sees that the Lord is standing for his chosen people. And that that power is nothing compared to what the Lord is going to do for his people.
And then, you know, it's funny too. We could tell the elites probably get dreams about brothers getting powers. Because how do they know brothers are going to get the power? They speak to left hand spirits. You know, spirits tell them.
Yeah.
You know, they go, hey, we try to grow in these men. They're going to, the Lord going to do some things for them. And they know that. They know our records. They know the men that our forefathers. They know about Samson. They know about King David. They know those men actually existed, our forefathers.
And they know the prophecies.
They know the prophecies.
That's why they, like we said, that's why they got rid of all those leaders in the past.
That's right.
They got rid of Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, the Panther Party. They got rid of all them guys.
And remember the Black Jesus story?
Yeah.
You know, with Simeon Toko? They said his name was Simeon Toko. You know, that whole Black Jesus story too, man. Right. Okay. What was the point of that?
What that? That looked like an Amalekite too.
Weird. People are weird.
People are just weird. Today.
And then what happened? They were shooing him, you know. They was chopping him up, you know. But he kept coming back to life. He kept, you know, reviving. And then he told him, as many more as gonna come like me in the end, basically, man.
That was a prophecy he gave.
That was a prophecy he told him, man. He could have been an angel, or you know, he could have been an angel, man. More than like he was an angel in a form of a man.
Now the Rothschilds, they have that in their records. You know, so that's why they constantly keeping their eye.
Yeah.
And that's why they try to get the elders of the past to sell out.
Yeah.
But they didn't think it would get this big, though. They're probably saying, you know, it's a local thing.
Just started right there in Harlem.
Yeah, there is no big thing. But
now it's global.
But now what really killed them is the internet. That's something that they don't have a control over, is the internet. See, and that was Yahweh Shemal Shah's doing. I tell you, Isaiah 52nd chapter, we all see together. Let's get that, actually.
So you say what? There's no language or tongue where the voice is not heard, man.
Yeah, the internet.
Internet, man. We're global.
There's no need to travel like Paul did. Mm-hmm. There's no need for that. Internet do everything.
You could be live. You know, even if you're not live, you could post a video up and have people from all over the world watch that same video at the same time. So you teaching mad people with different at one time.
People could rewind it.
Yep. That's perfect too for studying. You could just pause it, rewind, you know, go back, save videos, and go back to it just in case you don't got time to, you know, finish the whole thing at that moment. You know,
social media it was a two-edged sword. Yeah, you see a lot of people folly, and you see people's true spirit, their true self.
Yeah.
But also, information is spreading fast.
Right.
There's no need, like we said, to physically travel. There's no need to even go to libraries anymore. There's no need for that. Everything is online.
That's right.
Everything, man. Everything is easier now. Okay, Ed.
What do you want me to start in Isaiah 52nd?
God, what is it? They all see together? Let me see.
Isaiah 50 chapter 52 verse 8. Thy watchmen shall lift up the voice, with the voice together shall they see, for they shall see eye to eye when the Lord shall bring against Zion.
This is right now. Lifting up the voice together is by the internet. It's all connected. That's the main device that connects all of us. It's the internet by the unicorn. Okay? That's how the watchmen, we're singing a song together at the same time via internet. That's how brothers from whatever can connect with such and such. That's how you brothers and sisters from the other ends of the earth could hear this word. It's by the internet. They're not just going to say in Daniel 12 chapter, let's get that knowledge shall increase.
Right.
On the right and the left hand side. Alright? Before, militarily, everybody had the same technology. Then you had the Industrial Revolution, and now you got helicopters, planes, missiles, drones. Right? Now it's like I got Talos. It's just off the wall. Or the right hand, too, like we said, through the internet, information spread fast. You see? This is something that they can't control. So they eventually they have to just knock the power out, man. But it's too late. You see what I'm saying? Pandora's box been open already. It's too late. The secrets is already out. Alright? I think Yahweh Shai said that in the kingdom of heaven. It's like a mustard seed, but then it grows into the biggest tree. To where we're the talk of the town. Everybody got to talk about it. You have to. Right? Everybody know about the Israelites already. Everybody, these churches are talking about the Israelites, right? Some agreeing, some saying this shit. It doesn't even matter, man. But everybody knows. Controversy, just like the book of Acts, right? The word got so crazy, got to the word of the king, got to Nero. See, and he was getting pissed off with the Christians, storing them in the arenas and whatnot. The scripture says Claudius kicked the Jews out of Rome. This word was just becoming Rome, just a thorn in Rome's side, man.
Right. And this is Rome 2.0. Yeah. Maybe living in the book of Acts 2.0, man. Okay, so that's how you know the miracle is going to come. But this is a miracle in itself, the Great Awakening. I was waking up to this, the truth, through the spirit of power, Yahweh Bashi Mount Shah. Okay, so how much more the actual, like the physical, you know, raising the dead, healing the sick, all that going to be happening soon, man. You see? And that's how a lot more people, you know, the elect will get sealed, man, by believing in the works of the men of the Lord.
One third, yeah.
One third. The spirit out of ones that we all endure, we believe without seeing. We didn't have to see.
Yeah, that's a greater blessing.
That's a greater blessing, you know. Yahweh shouted out to Thomas. I think it was Thomas. Blessed is he that believe and have not seen.
You saw because that's why you believe.
Yeah.
I want to see the actual wound. He said, blessed I believe it and see it's not. He said, I don't believe unless I actually see.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that's what is the term, doubt in Thomas.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Yeah, man. That's what faith is, believing without seeing.
That's right. That's
such a foreign concept now. Even Jake, they don't want to hear about the Bible and spirituality. Every time you mention God, especially a lot of these guys, like we said, mentioning some kind of influence, you see them start rolling their eyes like, listen, we on earth. Let's deal with what we see and this, that, and third.
Like
we
got
to
deal said.
Right here. Like the Most High got nothing to do with the affairs of man on the planet. He's just chilling in the heavens. Everything on earth starts from the spiritual realm first, man. Then it plays out here, man. Okay? What did Yahweh Shai say? Matthew 10:29. Let's get that. So you think you're doing your own thing? You think you even come up with an idea? The Most High put through his Allah, I ain't put those ideas in your mind, man. Didn't Nikola Tesla say he used to get visions? He came up with the whole AC, alternate current? One of the smartest men? It was the Most High was giving him those things, man. It was the Most High gave you devils the inspiration to smith to destroy, to create those nuclear weapons, the wise men of Teman. He gave it to you, man. Okay? This whole smartphone technology, all that come from Yahweh Bashem Yahshua, man. Right? And that benefit us. Things is easy. Look up information. Boom, boom. The Urim and the Thurim. Everything's fast, instant. See? That's the Lord, man. What you got?
Matthew 10:29. Are not two sparrows sold for a farthing? And one of them shall not fall on the ground without your father.
Yeah, so a bird can't hit the ground unless the father gives a command. So everything you do, the Most High is in control of it. Right? And that's how proud a lot of these Jakes are, man. So you have money and that fame is just stumbling blocks, man. She would tell you that, brother. Quoted earlier, 1 Corinthians 6:7. Let's get that. That's a snare, man. You know, you always see it with these guys when they start ascending. You know, humble beginnings, humble. You know, and then when that money come in and. You know, they get their first award, I thank Jesus and God, and then after that, you can forget that. You know, they start throwing up the different weirdo signs, you know, start joining different groups, and that whole God thing, they throw up behind it. All right, what you got?
It's like, what was it again?
I think 1 Timothy 6 or 7.
That's what it was. 1 Timothy 6, verse 7. Nine, it says, but they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts. It says, which draw men to destruction and perdition.
Yeah, hurtful lust, man. I should tell you that it was the 1 Peter, the 4th chapter. Let's get that 1 Peter 4.
Okay. You hold it
up to it? Oh, yeah, I got some.
Okay. First Peter 4, right? It's like
4 and 1 verse again.
1 Peter 4:1. For as much then as Hamashiach has suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind, for he that have suffered in the flesh have ceased from sin. Verse 2, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of the Most High.
Yeah, the lust of men. Scripture gives you old examples of that. 1 John, the 2nd chapter. The lust of the eyes, man. Being what? Covetous.
Right.
It's not of the Father. Mm. All right, go ahead.
It says verse 3.
That's what Scripture also said. The covetous man, he set his own what? His own soul's sale.
That's right.
No? Selling out, man, for what? Some temporary. Scripture calls what? Consolation. Secondary prize. Kanye, keep talking to these Moses. You're not Moses. Moses gave up those things. Hebrews 11 chapter tells you that. In order to become a prophet, you're not going to give up your billions of dollars to hear this word, to truly come into this thing. Right? Did Malachi tell you right now to shut down and be quiet? You're going to shut down, man.
Well, I believe he's apologizing.
Yeah, because the Amalekite, he knows in order to make it in that world, you need the Amalekite. It's impossible for you to become a billionaire. Like, yeah, this whole, what is it? I don't know that stupid shit, that Yeezy sneakers.
Yeezys.
Yeah, and I think it, who distributed it? Adidas, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you need them, man, in order to distribute your goods. Because he has a bigger name. How come he couldn't distribute himself, man?
Mm.
But you know he need them in order to make shit happen, man. Okay, you could start your own money and your record label, but the shit ain't gonna go far. You need the Amalekite, you need the industry to push it, man. Right? Because why? This kingdom was given to them. That's what I'm saying. Go to your enemy for one of all things. Tell you that the children of this world and generation are wiser than the children of light. When it comes to money and business, you can't beat the Amalekite. That's his gift. Right? The Most High gave him those things, man. Right? Because then that parable, it says that guy came up with a scheme to save his Lord's business. That's what Yahushua said, make friends with what? Make friends of the world, right? Because they may have access to certain things, certain business, certain ideas, and they can help you out to some degree, right? Just be wise, but we don't spiritually or socially come together with them. We use it for what we can, right? Because the earth is given to them. It's given to him. See? So, you know, Kanye talking, you're not a revolutionary in anything, man. You're full of shit. And you sold your soul a long time ago.
Long time ago.
Right?
He said he never, like you said, he never canceled those statements.
He
said he sold his soul.
Yeah.
It was a crappy deal. At least it had came with folks who was like a happy deal.
Yeah, man. So, man, you're Malachi. Some IUIC and some of them guys did because they under charters. That's why they don't question the name of that. Instead of third because they under charters. that's a muzzle on your mouth. Yeah, so I told you about the bribes. Is it Exodus, the 23rd chapter? About bribes? Let's get that. Let's see. Somewhere in there. Somewhere in the law. Right?
I typed in bribes. And he said bribes, right?
Yeah.
So Exodus 23, somewhere in there. Is it 102? So you can't make what good judgment. So you took certain rewards on the side, man. So that perverts your judgment. This example of perverted judgment. The name of the Lord don't matter. Why doesn't it matter all of a sudden? Because you took a bribe. That goes against your contract. Because you're tax exempt. You get other stipends from the government. Right? That's what you want your body and members to sign non-disclosure agreement. All this wickedness going on. IUIC, man. You can't speak on certain things that go on in there. Why not? But is that a Masonic organization that you got to sign these agreements? That's just crazy wicked.
IUIC might just be a cult.
Yeah, that's a lot of cultist type of bullshit going on in there, man. Right, but the Most High eventually he was gonna expose you. Gonna expose you, man. All right. Yahweh shines the light. Eventually, he's going to put that light on you, man. And bring certain information out.
It's good to go into how you search Jerusalem with candles.
Search Jerusalem with candles. Okay?
Crazy.
Yeah. Great revelation. He examined the seven churches.
Yeah.
A lot of you into the spirit of Balaam, man. Meaning, well, he was a prophet for what? For hire.
For hire. Glad y'all ain't doing it
for money. And scriptures tell you, he used to use both. Divination and whichever one was more profitable is the word he sided with. That's a lot of you guys, man. You in that same spirit, man. All right? Now prophecy kind of winning. Now you want to, oh, yeah, we did. You never said that. You said there was no Jacob's trouble. Now Benjamin's cutting your ass.
Yeah.
Now all of a sudden you see prophecy. He got to speak on it. Right? Now, the MOTB brothers say they look like they kind of trying to come around. But then, you already clearly said, it's June, ain't no Mike. You said it.
You said it. And then he also tried to kind of like get us to the point where you can repent for taking the CHIP.
Nah, there's no, see? Come on, man.
Ain't none of that, man. That's what you got to tell Yasha Allah what it is, man.
And you got, like we were with the C-19.
You can't beat around the bush and give him uncertainty. Okay.
You can't, no gray areas.
No gray areas. You have to
let it be known. This is not allowed.
Yay be yay, nay be nay. Can I take no, you can't. What about the cracks? No, you cannot. Okay, we ain't say, oh well, technically it's not going off. You know what I'm saying?
But so I don't recommend it.
I don't recommend it, but now you got him all scared. And not scared of money. Like, should I? You know, you gotta give him a sign when the brother asked about the heart. So I said no.
You gotta be resolute. You gotta tell him, yo.
He said, what if I lose my job? You can get another one.
That's it.
That's it, man. That's it. Oh, one body was saying, oh, I'm not gonna tell you not to take it because I can't give you a job if you don't take it.
So you wicked.
Wicked, man.
That's a wicked nigga.
That's a wicked ass leader right there. See, that's why, man, like brother says, a lot of the elect is scattered amongst a lot of these camps. But one body, their leadership is clearly just fucking agents, man. clearly agents, man.
Man, nigga.
And now we're looking at IYC like, yo, y'all probably really done sold out, man. The way y'all, how y'all find a brother's social security numbers and shit? Non-disclosure agreements. You know, whatever goes in here, we can't speak about it outside. What are you talking about, man? See, that's all wickedness, man. That's all off, man. I mean, y'all doing something in the dark.
Y'all in league with Aisha Heavy.
Yeah.
Heavy.
They probably have an eating mice come by and, you know, yeah, pass, you know, talk to you. They probably, you can't talk, you know, don't tell that you saw Bishop Nathaniel speaking with this eating mice in the suit with a fucking briefcase in his hand.
The Rosicrucians coming by. But that's no different than the Pharisees in the scriptures.
That's right.
You know, they look righteous, but they taking their orders from the Roman Empire. They said, we have no king but Caesar.
Mm.
They said, if this man keep teaching, the Romans shall both come take away our place and nation. See? You know? Take away both our place and nation, man.
Right.
So who did their loyalty belong to? Romans. Right? Pilate. Caesar. They were down there with the restoration that they needed, man. They should have done that. The restoration of the tribes, because if they did, they would have sent away Yahushua.
When Yahushua raised Lazarus from the dead, they was doing them spies.
Body got to say about that. Well, that's not the word there. Or that don't mean that. You know, what do you say?
He probably sleeping, literally sleeping, taking a nap, and now try to tap them. We've seen him 4 days.
You got to be slow to listen to that guy. Once a real shit, you got to be real slow.
Yeah.
You know, ICBK, we didn't forget about them. John the Baptist was a wicked nigga. They actually said that.
And they recanted those statements. A lot of the statements they made, they recanted. They just came back to him and off. Lock you for that. They never did none of that, man.